Today we're in a county where in the 12th and 13th century a huge number of these massive castles, 50 at the last count, were built by English lords trying to shore up their defences against local chieftains. Find out where we are in just a moment on Escape to the Country.
Along this border territory between Wales and England, there's a unique dancing tradition that is rooted in the life of the area's agricultural workers. Border Morris is typified by a rowdy style of dancing that was first recorded in 1609 when a group, or side as they're known, performed at the Hereford races. Earlier in the week, I met up with the Widders from Chepstow, who are keeping this traditional dance alive. Border Morris is boisterous and often involves the beating of sticks in the routine. Early records show that the dancers often appeared in court for non-payment of bills or for being drunk and disorderly.
It's so anarchic. It's like the dark side of Cotswold Morris.
Traditionally, the dance is performed in the winter, both for fun, but also as a way of earning money. Taking a break from festivities is Mick Lewis to tell us more.
Mick, it's awesome. It's awesome. I was lucky enough to dance with a Morris side from the Cotswolds,
yeah,
which is like hankies and light and love,
yeah,
and you're sort of like
punk rockers for the Morris word.
Punk rockers, yeah. So what's the signal? Why the blackface for a start?
The originators of this type of dancing, they were poor people that lived off the land, and this is a begging tradition really, and because they lived in small communities, they felt embarrassed about begging money, and so they used to black their face
up. Disguise.
It's a disguise, yes.
Right.
Now, the Mary Lloyd is a very special little... She's beautiful, isn't she?
He's skinny.
Railway man, he works hard, shunted on the Bristol Yard, cos the Severn Tunnel never, ever fails. Keeps the engine on the
The Mary Lloyd is a Welsh custom of first footing, where a group carrying a horse skull go from house to house to bring people good luck for the new year. The dancers wear tattered clothes, a symbol of times past when they wouldn't have been able to afford new outfits. And the Widders name itself comes from a rather unusual source.
And why Widders? Is that to do with the spiders?
It's to do with the spiders, yeah. It's to do with...
Black Widders.
It's the Black Widows, yeah. And we like to be colourful. You know, we've sort of evolved this style of our own, which is the Chepstow style, or the Wye Valley style.
I am, of course, itching to have a go.
About a week, you'll be all right.
Yeah. I've got to work tomorrow.
The dances are always about the area's events or people. And I'm performing a dance known as the Severn Tunnel Junction, a place where many locals were employed on the Great Western Railway. The hazel sticks represent the shunting poles the railway workers used to link the wagons together.
One, two, three! Hey!
You're staying with us!
I really enjoyed that. But now it's time to wipe off the makeup and get back to the job in hand.